In this video, I'm going to demonstrate how to create a special program in PowerSchool that will allow Rise to pull the information from PowerSchool to be able to create an IEP. This is the same process as it was in the past with Elite. So once I've looked up my student, I'm going to scroll down to Courses and Programs. I'm going to select Student Programs, and I'm going to select New. In here, I will enter the entry date, which is the first date of the program that the program started, that the student started. I'm going to leave the exit date and exit reason blank until the student is finished or has ended that program. Then I'm going to select Special Education. Down here, from the drop-down menu, I will be selecting an exceptionality. Students who have not had an IPRC must have an exceptionality of non-identified, and students who have been identified as an exceptional pupil must have the correct ministry definition selected here. For this student who is non-identified, I will select that. For the main exceptionality flag, this should be checked off for all students when the exceptionality is anything other than non-identified. Otherwise, it's left blank. Placement type. So all students must have a placement type, whether they have been identified as exceptional or not. For this student, because they have not been identified as an exceptional pupil through an IPRC, I'm going to select indirect service. However, you need to select the correct placement type based on the information that was gathered at the IPRC. The IPRC student flag must also be clicked if the student has had the IPRC. The IPRC review date must be entered for the last date of the last IPRC date or the last waived IPRC date. This date must be updated annually for the ministry, and it's important that the date is not entered in as a future date. It must be a past date. It's also important to note that this information, this IPRC review date, if it's done at certain times of the year, can create an error in OnSys. So I always double checked with my office administrator to make sure that that would line up. Usually I would enter these dates in at the end of June. And the final checkbox here is the individual education plan. This box must be checked for all students. So I'm going to select that, and then I would hit submit. Once I've hit submit, at the next refresh for the software, the data will be transferred over to Rise, and you will be able to create a new IEP. Again, this process is very similar to how it was with Elite. However, there are some new processes in the Rise part of the software, which I will demonstrate in a later video. Thanks very much.